The recently released 1.0.2.5 version of Order of Mister 2 includes several improvements to the game itself, but also new content, as well as interesting information regarding AMS2's planned future in terms of features and content. First of all, Razer gifted us a new car that is a completely free addition to Order of Mister 2's already reasonable collection. And as you could already see in the background, the mentioned car is none other than the McLaren MP4-12, which is set to broaden the V10 Generation 1 category. It was originally used by the McLaren F1 team in 1997 and featured an ingenious invention never seen in F1 before and afterwards. But this is due to it being banned in the following 1998 season. Additionally to the main braking system, McLaren installed an extra pedal which was able to control the inside rear brake and granted their drivers a few tenths per lap, as one could now basically rotate the car a bit more when using the system. The same configuration for a McLaren MP4-12 is, of course, also available in Auto Molista 2. And to make use of it, you have to bind a key to the handbrake slash extra brake option. Just make sure though that this key is not a digital one, meaning a button that just knows pressed or not pressed as its input, as you're probably going to spin due to locking your brakes immediately. Next on, I'm going to highlight a few changes from the actual patch before going into detail about the new roadmap, which is showcasing when new content or features, as for example the multiplayer rating system, will be released. Anyhow, this patch brought a few refinements regarding the force feedback. According to the patch notes, the scrub effect was re-enabled, a few force scalings were changed, and the feedback provided by curbs is a bit more detailed now. I honestly didn't feel much of a difference except for the curbs, as they feel a bit crisper now, I guess. In an attempt to reduce desync in multiplayer races, the tick rate was quote-unquote adjusted. It is not exactly stated whether it was increased or decreased, but I would assume the former is the case, unless the servers were overloaded with calculations, where the latter would make more sense. Now, let's finally move on to the new roadmap, and therefore, the release windows for new content and features. So, in September, we will get classic touring cars as a free addition. In October, the Nürburgring, and therefore presumably also simultaneously the Nordschleife, are available as DLC, and Razer finally adds a few GT3s and more GT4s to the game. In November, Group C and GT1 cars await us, and the historical track pack will be available for purchase. Lastly, in December, the Spa DLC and, more importantly, a multiplayer ranking system will be added to the game. Hand in hand with the newly announced tracks, also come a few new options to purchase those DLCs. Namely, the so-called premium track pack, which costs 36 € and features Hockenheim, Silverstone, the Nürburgring, Spa, and another track that was not announced yet. However, this pack solely includes set tracks with their current layouts and not in their historic forms. These layouts need to be purchased in the according historical track packs. So yeah, if you did enjoy this video, or got something useful out of it, you could consider subscribing for my sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!